As you hear by the beeps, new warnings are coming out. This one now going a little farther to the south, including Johnson County on the Kansas side. Fresh one stays in effect until 9:15. Still the possibility of damaging winds and damaging hail. To the west of that, we still have Douglas County under a severe thunderstorm warning until 9. And on the Missouri side, eastern Clay, most of Ray going into the western portion of Carroll County. That's a severe thunderstorm warning that's set to expire at the top of the hour, too, as we continue to see powerful thunderstorms rolling across the region. I do want to show right now, at least, this is going up to the north and east of Kansas City, where we still have at least 3/4 inch hail in diameter. That's the cell that is very close to converge onto Trenton, Missouri. Farther to the west we go, we see other redevelopment that has popped up. The heavier cells, which are in the yellow, those are the severe thunderstorm warnings that are out. Also, new ones that are now igniting farther to the south toward Lyon County on the Kansas side, including Emporia. So this area seems to be now the hotbed of activity as a new severe thunderstorm watch has been issued for the extreme southeastern corner of Kansas and going into the southwestern corner of Missouri, too. So it still looks like we're going to have a few more hours of the thunderstorm activity that's still out there. I was looking at one of our scout cameras just to see that for the most part, there are a few areas that are getting some of the rain. Otherwise, at 435 in Metcalf, although Johnson County is under that severe thunderstorm warning until 9:15, the roads are dry for the time being, but that's the cell that's moving from Douglas County and heading toward Johnson County on the Kansas side. And as you know, we've had reporters and crews out all evening long. This is live streaming coming in from Marcus Moore. Marcus, where's your location?
Well, Bryan, we are in the Northland, not too far away from 152, and actually we're headed over to 635 and 9 Highway, where we understand there may be an accident there involving a semi truck that apparently fell victim to some of those wind gusts that we've been experiencing tonight. A wind burst actually tipped the truck over. The good news we can report for you right now is that there were no injuries reported there. So we're headed that direction, but Bryan, I can tell you that we've seen quite a bit of activity here in the Northland this evening, beginning with those strong winds and then rain, and we ran into a good bit of hail along 435 towards KCI. That hail was in a very wide area. It seemed well over a mile and was quite heavy. We saw cars having to pull over, and so it's been very active here in the Northland. And as we wait for more of that rain to move through, we'll certainly look to see if conditions get any worse. Back to you.
Thank you there, Marcus Moore reporting. We do want to go to, if we can, this is now StormView Doppler Radar showing you those thunderstorm clusters that are moving through. Live First Alert Doppler Radar with more that's starting to redevelop farther to the southwest. Another report that came in at about 8:15, ping pong ball size hail being reported near I-35. That was mainly on the Kansas side. So once again, there are reports that are coming in here. Also reports of ping pong ball size hail to the north along I-35 on the Missouri side, too. And as Marcus mentioned, close to 635 and 9, that's where the semi was overturned. We'll continue to compile reports and still track the storms. But for now, that's the very latest from the First Alert Weather Center.